Welcome to Smallville Fanatic Reviews. Hey Superman, what did you think of the first episode of my reviews?
It sucked.
Well, here's episode 2. Come on, get off the chair, I need to do a review. So we open outside Lana's house, and there's some creepy guy in her tree with a camera who broke into her house and left her present. Someone should call the Pope. Hey, that's pretty good footage. Can I have a copy of that?
Is this what you do with your time now, Greg?
I was going to edit out the fapping noises, I swear.
Tonight? Oh. I was out collecting.
Two disgusting habits.
Insects aren't disgusting, Mom.
Monday morning, I am phoning Claremont Military Academy.
Jeez, lady. He's hardly a problem child. Sure, collecting insects is unusual, but it's hardly a reason for punishment. And you didn't even try to solve the stalking issue.
Pay attention, kiddies. That's kryptonite in the bug tank. Okay, maybe I was wrong. I think this is cause for concern. And nothing quite says rebellious teenager quite like driving recklessly while listening to the suicidal rock of Papa Roach. So his kryptonite-infected bugs get loose and begin to attack him. He pulls a Peter Parker.
And now has super insect powers!
Now Clark steps up to show how creepy stalking is really done.
It's all your fault, Clark.
You just can't compete with Clark.
Clark!
Oh, it was all a dream. How lame.
Clark, we're leaving.
But hey, he was flying! That's so cool! I can't wait to see Clark flying around. That's going to be awesome!
Clark, I didn't see you at the dance last night.
Oh, I was a little tied up.
This is one thing that really annoys me about this story. Clark is a lot taller and hell of a lot more muscular than Whitney. Seriously, Whitney? Why is Clark getting bullied by this guy? I mean, not to mention, he's freaking Superman!
Why does he always act so submissive when he's nigh invincible and could punch Whitney into the sun?
Thank you, Mr. Kent.
I'm gonna get the rest of the boxes out of the truck.
I know the scriptwriters were trying to make it so Clark is like a normal teenager in many respects, so that we can relate to him better, and that he's from a loving family, and brought up to be a kind and caring person. But come on! I'd at least stand there with a smug grin on my face because I know I could crush Whitney's skull into dust!
Anyway, our third stalker moment as Peter Parker's lame cousin shows up with clear skin, newfound confidence, and Christian Bale face. Whitney threatens him to stay away from Lana. Jeez, this guy has some severe jealousy issues.
You afraid of a little competition, Whitney?
So American Psycho here causes Whitney to have a car crash in revenge. But Clark saves him. Smokin'!
Dad, something else happened to me this morning. When I woke up, I was kind of floating.
Oh sweet! He's gonna be learning to fly by the end of the episode! I just know it!
Lana rides horses. She must have strong thighs. Does that mean she knows reverse cowgirl? Anyway, Christian Bale kills his mother with his trusty web shooter.
Now, I've always thought it was pretty stupid that Spider-Man's webbing never came out of his ass. But this guy's web comes out of his mouth. I mean, how much sense does that make?
Lex wants to help Clark win Lana away from Whitney, so he gives him Lana's lost kryptonite necklace, rather luckily in a lead box, which is the only substance that apparently can insulate against kryptonite's effects.
Lana! Hey!
I just love how they play that cliched insect sound effect whenever this guy appears.
You remember the English paper? Are you blowing me off for your boyfriend?
I wish she'd blow me off! Sorry, I had to.
Clark realizes the green meteor rock makes his hands age rapidly and returns home to find Lana in his barn.
This is an amazing place.
My dad built it. He calls it my fortress of solitude.
Do you can see my house from here?
No, really? You know, we've...
I love how he plays that off so casually as he blatantly moves the telescope that was pointing at her bedroom.
Clark feels conflicted about returning Lana's necklace. Since it makes him ill, he won't be able to be near her, so he decides to do the right thing and keep it so that he can get some hot Lana action.
Sounds kind of weird, but it's made from a fragment of the meteor that killed my parents.
For someone who's not the least bit emo, she sure obsesses over the death of her parents quite a lot.
Life is about change.
If I can change.
Sometimes it's painful.
And you can change.
Sometimes it's beautiful.
Everybody can change!
The time is both.
Later that night, Christian Bale attacks his newest love rival, but Clark fends him off.
Clark?
I'm gonna go, do you want me to go fucking trash your lights? Do you want me to fucking trash them? Am I gonna walk around and rip your fucking lights down?
The sign says fly to victory. That's a hint that Clark's gonna fly by the end of the episode.
I can't wait!
Time for Chloe to figure out what's going on. Let's see if she can beat last week's record.
I found an article about Amazonian tribesmen who took on the traits of the insects they've been bitten by, but nothing as extreme as what you're talking about. Did you have any luck?
Only that Greg didn't move to Smallville until after the meteor shower, so he couldn't have been exposed to the blast.
Yeah, but his bugs could have been. Think about it, Clark. Pieces of that meteor are still buried all over Smallville. The whole habitat's infected. So when boy catches bugs and bugs bite boy, you end up with Bug Boy.
If I ever start a detective agency, I'm hiring Chloe.
So Clark finds Bug Boy about to have his wicked way with Precious Lana.
Get away from her. Greg, I know what's happened to you.
Oh, good for you!
You're a slave to your instincts.
I'm not asking, I'm telling you. Why are you trashing my scene?
I go where I want.
I'm gonna fucking kick your fucking ass. You know, shut up for a second, all right?
You're not taking her.
What don't you fucking understand? Kick your fucking ass!
So they have a bit of a fight and Christian accidentally kills himself. That's a little anticlimactic. At least I think he killed himself.
Seriously? Did he turn into lots of bugs and get away? Or was he crushed and lots of bugs came out of him? This is the end of the episode and it's not very clear!
But Whitney's the one who actually releases Lana, so he comes out the hero. Poor Clark.
He can't tell anyone that he stopped the Bug Boy, because that will just raise suspicions about his own powers.
Whitney?
Clark finally decides to return the necklace anonymously.
You know what? I just remembered. Clark didn't actually fly in this episode. Never mind. I'm sure it'll happen in the next episode, right?